Amazon is gearing everybody to brand registry.
And here we go.
Everybody needs to get a brand. Get branded. They want you to have a store. So, what do I do? Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Not a problem. This is what we want to do. If you live in the United States, you can do this yourself. It's so simple that you don't need to hire a third party. If you live outside the United States, you will need an attorney to do it for you. You can find one at LegalZoom. You can find one at Inkfile. You can go to Fiverr. Just Google, where can I get an attorney to file a trademark for me? But this is what we're looking for right here. Search trademark database. We want to make sure nobody has it. United States Patent and Trademark Office. If you can't remember which order they go in, just remember P becomes before T in the alphabet. So we're going to go ahead and click on that. This is what we want to do. The very first thing we want to do is a trademark search. Very simple. The very first one. We want a word mark. Okay, so we're going to come up with a name. Now, I want to sell backpacks, the military backpacks. So I'm going to go with LT Dan's just to see what happens. I don't know. Ah, Lieutenant Dan. So somebody did pick it. But I'm getting creative here. So I'm going to pick another one. Let's see. Groggies. Yeah, that's a name. Groggies has another one. A bunch too. Not a problem. Huffernicks. Okay, let's see what's going on there. Excellent. That's what I want to see. So my new name that I've chosen is going to be Heffernix. So this is what we want to see. No records were found. And I want to see all this white space. Awesome. This is what I'm looking for. So I've decided on my name. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back to USPTO and USPTO is going to take me to trademark application. So we're going to start filling out our application. It is not difficult. It should take you about 15 minutes to do.
That's not so hard.
Remember, if you're doing it from the United States like I am, this is how we're going to do it. We picked the first one, $250 per class. This will include your trademark name. So every class you choose, be very careful. It will cost you $250. So we picked the first one. If you are outside the United States, you will pick yes. Inside, because it will ask you, is an attorney filing the application for you? No, it is, they are not. And I'm just going to continue. I'm already on to page two. So what I'm going to do is owner of the mark. I'm going to do it as John Smith. Basically, I have an individual LLC because I tend to want to do mine as a company. I am doing business as, and I'm going to do business as Huffernicks. Huffernicks. And there we go. I'm looking for the one that has the LLC. Okay. LLC, limited liability company. And that's what I want to see. So now it's going to ask me a couple of questions. Okay. Where am I filing for? Let's just say California. They have high taxes there. Wyoming. There it is. If not a U.S. citizen, then you will click this next one. Now, the next one is mailing address. Everything that has a red asterisk, we are going to fill out. 123 Smart Street. And we're going to go in the city of Boringtown. Okay. So let me see. The state is going to be, once again, we're going to be in Wyoming and United States zip code. I have no idea what Wyoming is. 10134. We'll just put it in there and see if it sticks. Now, this is the critical part right here. See this email address? You want this. Okay. So I'm going to do 123huff@gmail.com. Okay. This is critical because this is the only way that USPTO will contact you is through email. They will never contact you through mail. So if you get mail saying, oh, there's an office action. Oh, you need to do this. Oh, you need to put money down here. Throw it in the trash. It is junk mail. USPTO will never contact you through your mail. The only time you will get anything from them is when you've earned your trademark and they will send you your certificate. That is it. So we're going to go ahead and continue. It'll let us know if we messed anything up. Important note, telephone number. Okay, they used to not ask for the telephone number, but apparently they are asking for it now. So I am going to do this. I'm going to make sure I have my telephone number, fax number, phone number. Okay, let's see if we missed. Oh, we're good. We're going on to the next one. Okay, I want the standard character. Now in this box, we're just going to do Huffernicks. Huffernicks. That's what I want. Okay, check here to display the full and additional statements. I don't need any other statements, so I'm just going to go ahead and continue. So I want my standard character mark, and I'm going to continue. It'll always tell me if I miss something. Okay, we're good to go. Now we want to know, what are we going to sell? So this is where I was talking about your goods and services. So we want to go in here. Go as generic as possible to find your product. Sunglasses. Let's just go. Okay. So it's going to bring up all my categories. I'm going to look for something that it look. Okay. Sunglasses is 09. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on every single 09 in here because case for spectacle for glasses. I can sell a case. It's also in one category. I'm still, as many as I'm clicking, it's all 009. And this is going to allow me to sell everything in 0009. So if I sell sunglasses, I can sell magnetic clips on sunglasses. I can sell chains. I can sell lenses. I can sell cords. I can sell anything that is in this 009, and it won't cost me any extra money.
Nice.
So I'm going to insert my entries, and it's going to should come up in orange. There should be something going on. Eyewear, namely, remove. Why? Sunglasses for outdoors. I don't know. Sun. I don't know. Please specify the requirement. I don't know. Okay. Rental of sunglasses, spectacles. So I don't see any reason for any of these. So I'm going to go ahead and remove it and remove my issue. And it doesn't really make a difference because I still have all of this. And I'm going to go ahead and insert entry. And there we go. We're all up. I can sell all of these under 009 under the name Huffernix. The next thing you want to do is, I know that there's a box, select 1B. It's not in use, but I intend to use it. So because USPTO wants you to use this. So I'm going to click 1B. Okay. I understand that I intend to use this. So I'm going to say, I understand. Okay. And we're good here. And we're good. And this is your final one. Assign a filing basis. Excellent. That's what we want. So we're going to click the box, assign a filing basis. Everything looks good. It wants you to check it over again. Good to go. And continue. Excellent. So it is telling me that I have email correspondence here, secondary email, no need. My name is John Smith, docket reference number they will provide. And I'm going to go ahead and continue. Everything looks good. My email is up there. I'm going to go ahead and continue. All right. And now it's going to cost me $250. And they are going to give me, I'm going to sign here. I'm going to date it. I'm going to sign here. I'm going to sign here. And I'm going to validate it. Okay. And you're basically going to pay it. And I'm going under basic. So make sure you click your basic and make sure you sign and date and follow all the red here. You're going to validate and it's going to take you to the payment page. And you've just applied for your trademark. It is going to give you a serial number. Copy that serial number down. And they're going to send you a letter immediately with the serial number. So you can look over everything, print it out. Make sure you have a hard copy of it and save it in case you need it for later. So that is how you file for a trademark.
That was easy.
It is not difficult. You can do it yourself. Just make sure that you pay attention to when you are looking for something specific that you pick the correct category. Because when you're going to apply for brand registry at Amazon, because they want you branded, they want you to build a store, because you want to become successful. And this is the best way to become successful. And if you like what we're doing, go ahead and click the like button. Let me know. If you want to see something else, let me know and be more than willing to get it up for you. Mahalo and have an awesome day.